Let's now talk about looping or repetition. So in this session, we shall try to address the need for looping or repetition in programming. What is looping or what is repetition? And through a simple example, I shall just explain to you the concept of looping or repetition. Now, why do we need iterations or loops? Now, if you look at it, let's take a few examples. Say you are processing the salary of 10,000 employees. So for each of the employees, you're going to read his or her name, the basic salary. Then based on the basic salary, you're going to calculate the HRA, the city compensatory allowance, the dearness allowance, the tax deductions, and finally, the total salary due to the employee. This process is going to be repeated for each of those 10,000 employees. So if you see, there is a similar processing for each of those employees starting from the first employee till the 10,000th employee. So this is an example of the same kind of code being run again and again on different employees. Another example, when your marks cards are published by, say, the Central Board of Secondary Education or your university, they are basically going to be done through repetition or iteration logic. For each student, I am going to get the marks for different subjects, calculate the total, calculate the percentage, and print the result. So examples of salary calculation, getting the student's marks card, or details of sales by the salesperson are repetitive tasks which are excellent examples of doing using iteration or looping statements. Now, the advantage of using computers for looping or iteration is computers being machines do not get bored. Unlike a human being, say I tell you, I want you to write your name 10 million times. Obviously, none of you are going to enjoy the task of writing your own name 10 million times. But if I write a small computer program and I print your name 10 million times or even 100 million times, the computer is not going to show any emotion because it's a machine. It's simply going to perform the task you have instructed it to do. Now, as you're doing repeated tasks, you will also be calculating salary totals for the department, average marks by department, or average marks by the college, or average marks by the university, average marks by state and all. These are very good examples of doing repetition. Let's try to answer the question, what exactly are loops? So loops are a body of statements, that is, they are zero or more instructions which are executed repeatedly again and again based on some Boolean expression or some condition. In some cases, as long as the condition is true, I may execute the statements a specific number of times. Sometimes I may have a loop which never terminates. It may keep executing endlessly. This is called as an infinite loop. So the body of a loop consists of zero or more statements, and it is controlled by the means of a Boolean expression. So in most of the times, as long as the Boolean expression is true, I am going to continue to execute those body of instructions again and again till the Boolean expression becomes false. In one other case, if I'm using the repeat until loop, I may execute the body of the loop as long as the condition is false. So in order to understand what are loops and how do loops really work, or how do loops used in programming, let's take the case of a small example. So in this illustration, what I'm doing is I'm asking a user to guess a lucky number between 1 to 50. The difference in this program is he can keep entering as many times as he wants till he finally enters the lucky number. In my case, I have chosen 44 to be equal to the lucky number. I am doing a looping statement using a repeat until construct or a repeat until statement. The difference between other loops and repeat until is repeat until is going to execute this particular block of statements until the condition is false. The minute the user enters 44, it is going to stop. So let me explain to you different aspects of a loop. So I am doing a start. I take a variable and give it the name number. Then between 2 to 5, this is one instruction, this is the second instruction. So between 2 to 5, this instruction is going to be executed again and again as long as the value of the number entered by user is not equal to 44. So as long as this condition is false, this is going to execute. In most of the loops, we are going to execute blocks as long as the condition is true. So what I am doing is I am saying repeat. I am asking the user guess a number between 1 to 50. The user enters a number, let's say he enters 10. Since 10 is not equal to 44, okay, it will again come. It will ask him again enter the number. This way the user is keeps on going entering the number. Say at some point he enters the number 44. Now since number is equal to 44, this condition becomes true. So once it becomes true, I come out here and I print the message, you guessed it right, and stop. So this is an example of a looping statement. Anything between repeat and until gets executed till the user enters 44. Or this is also known as iteration. Repeatedly executing a set of statements in a block is known as iteration or looping. Let me tell you what I mean by a block. So suppose I have, this is a block. So I have one instruction here followed by a semicolon, second instruction here followed by a semicolon. So here generally what I do is I have a condition. So as long as this condition is true, okay, I will keep executing these statements again and again. The minute this condition becomes false, what I am going to do is I am going to come out here of the loop. This is the normal loop, but in our loop here, what we have done is we have done it a little reverse. I am executing the loop as long as the condition is false. That means as long as I am not entering 44, I am continuing to do this particular block of instructions. That's why I'm using a repeat until loop. So this should hopefully help you understand what a loop is and how it is used in programming.